In League of Legends, the recall ability teleports the player to the spawn point. This is characterized by a nice graphic effect that can change depending on the champion skin. In this video, we recreate this effect on Unity. Let's start analyzing which parts make up this effect. We've created them separately and then combined all the parts at the end. At the beginning of the animation, a light beam appears in the center, where light circles propagate on the ground. Once the beam ends, a bigger circle expands. It is composed by a color gradient with two main points of illumination. Meanwhile, vertical particles start moving. Now, new external light circles appear. The first circles move vertical, disappearing, and on their edges are projected vertical lines. At the end of the animation, the character disappearing and appears in the spawn point, with a particle effect similar to the previous one but lighter. To start, we realized two basic images. A simple circle with a glow effect and a larger circle. The larger circle is shaded in a way that creates 2 points brighter and 2 points darker. We imported these images in Unity and create a parent of our particles. The beam consists of a single particle with no emission shape and speed. This particle is stretched vertically and changes its X scale during the lifetime. We've set the curve so that it decreases very quickly at the beginning. We created the first color gradient using white and light blue, and shaded the edges so the particle obtained a fade effect. Light circles are created in the same way. They don't have emission shape and speed, but they expand outwards. Particles are horizontal beerboard and use material with associated one of the imported images. To realize the circular gradient, we created a new alpha blended material that used the second image we imported. As for the beam, it is a single particle that expands very quickly and rotates on itself. To enhance this particle, we duplicated it and its material, but we have set the material as additive. Then, we have modified the colors, creating this way a beautiful light effect when they overlap. The external circles are similar to the first one, but they have a larger scale and greater delay. Vertical lines use particles stretched on the y-axis. We have modified the cone shape so it becomes a cylinder. Thanks to the velocity and the duration, we have decided how tall a particle is. We have created vertical circles as the first we have made, but here we maintained the shape and velocity. We have modified again the cone shape so it becomes a cylinder. External vertical lines are a copy of the other one we have made. They have the same radius of the external circles, but a lower duration, so they disappear first. Once the particle is created, we have downloaded two animations from Mixamo. One for the idle phase and one for the recoil phase. We imported the animations on Unity and realized a controller that switched between them using a trigger. We have created a script called Recoil that synchronizes the phases. Through a coroutine, we have instantiated the VFX prefab and started the recoil animation. Then we wait for 8 seconds, the base duration of the recoil. And at the end of this time, we move the player to another position and start another animation. Starting from the element we have already made, we have developed the second phase. We use only the vertical beam, moving circles and external lines. We changed the colors and the durations, in particular, circles move downwards. In the script, we added the new prefab and the camera. In the start method, we calculated the offset that exists between the camera and the player. We also move it after 8 seconds. To improve the movement visibility, we added a simple element to the scene. To improve the effect, we modified again the sync variables until we got the best result. We installed the post-processing package and used ambient occlusion and bloom to achieve a better result and highlight the light points. This is the final result. What do you think about it? Tell us in a comment below and don't forget to subscribe. See you next time. Cheers!